Hi everyone, this is Oz with PubNub. I'm the product manager for ChatEngine. In this video, I'll show you how to build a simple chat app with ChatEngine in a few short minutes. So what we start here is a CodePen template that has some HTML and CSS, which gives us a UI to build with, and a skeleton JavaScript application that knows how to render messages, scroll the screen and whatnot, but all the ChatEngine code is missing in this template, so we're gonna fill it in to get it right now. The first thing we do is we instantiate an instance of ChatEngine and we provide our publish and subscribe keys. You will get these keys when you first configure your account for ChatEngine, and that's on our quick start guide. So don't worry about this step, it'll be given to you. And the next thing we will do is create a variable for our chat. It's called MyChat. ChatEngine calls rooms chats, so it's analogous. A chat and a room is analogous. And the next step is connecting to PubNub. What we provide here is a new person object. It's essentially a generated random profile. It has a UID and an object that provides its avatar image. And we continue on by adding a callback for the ready event that ChatEngine will fire. When it's fired, it means that we can start interacting with the ChatEngine. And here's how we create a new chat, essentially a new chat room. We call it ChatEngine demo chat and assign it to the variable that we declared earlier, my chat. And what's next is we want to start listening to messages that are coming on this chat. And so we register a callback for message events and call render message with the messages we receive. The next step is registering a callback for sending messages. And now we go to the predefined function for sending these messages and add in the ChatEngine code for sending messages to a chat room. And this is it, guys. So I just saved it up top and then sent our first message. Now I'm going to switch to an incognito window and chat with myself. Let's see, expand that real quick. And hello, hello. As you can see, we just chatted with ourselves. Now that we have a working chat application, let's make it a little bit more interesting by adding some features, like presence. Presence is the feature that shows us which users are online and which users are offline. So I just added these three lines to listen for users that are coming online. The event we're listening to is $.online.star, and you can see that on the right side, it populated the list of users that are online. It's awesome to track users that are coming online, but we also want to track when they go offline. So we're just going to add another three lines for that. And we will listen to the offline events. These events are fired when people leave the chat room. So we can go update the user list and show the accurate list of users that are online. We're only one feature away from an awesome chat app, and that's message history. You may be reloading your app or just joining a channel. You want a brief context of what people are talking about, right? So I'm just gonna add about six lines of code, and that's gonna give us message history for our channel. Boom. I pasted the code and CodePen reloaded. We already have a bunch of chat history coming up. So it's loading, that's why the cursor is actually snapping down. And let me give you a quick walkthrough of what we are doing here. So we're listening for the connected event on our chat, which is our chat room, essentially. And we're running a function called search and listening for the messages that are coming from it. We're asking for 50 messages, and it's gonna bring us the last 50 messages in this chat room. And as we receive these messages, we just render them just like normal messages. The only difference is we actually prepend instead of appending, and that's about it.